Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chain Design Channel. Today we are going to talk about this B setting on the wire construction ring. Are you ready? Let's get started. When we are starting, we always want to start with the ring sizer. Let's set it up for the diameter for 16mm. And then we want to thinking about how wide this thing is going to be. So let me go ahead to use the surface tool. Then you have extruded surface and you want to extrude something like that. This is how wide you want it to be. Then we want to start drawing the curve. I'm going to use the arc tool and I'm going to start here and drawing something like this. I mean, you can draw something really big or really small. It's up to you and depends on how you like those two curves to be. So now we are in the ghost view. We can kind of see it. If you want them to be touched, you might want to get them a little bit closer. You can make them asymmetrical or whatever that you like. So we basically get those two curves. Next things we wanted to do, we want those two curves on that surface. So let's go ahead to project this to the surface and then we will get those two curves. We no longer need this original curve, so let's just go ahead to delete it. And this is what we can see over there. All right, on the bottom, I would like to have it close as possible. So I'm going to lock my original one and I'm gonna quickly draw a straight line right there. And using that straight line to trim the bottom curve that I don't need. All right, so now I make the bottom open. At this point, if you feel like the button is too wide, you can go ahead to make it smaller. However, now, since we project this curve, so it has a lot of point right there, we can go ahead to use the rebuild tool and we will rebuild it to make it less. So it will be easier to editing. Maybe a little bit more less to be 12. As long as the shape is not changing too much, you will be fine. So I'm gonna do the same thing over here to turn it into 12. Okay, so now I can kind of work with it to make it closer if I want to, for example. Turn on the control point and select those points on the bottom and kind of have them coming in a little bit more like this. So they will go in a little bit more. Like this way. Same thing I can do on the other side is I can move it in a little bit if I do want them to come in a little bit closer. So it's up to you about the design that you wanted to do, but I will highly encourage you to try a few more times to actually get it flowing really well. Now we have the curve roughly going to what we want. We want to connecting those curves back. So I'm going to use the blend command. We are going to blend the curve from this point to this point. And you can adjust it if it is too long. I'm going to move it back just a little bit so it's not overlapping too much. We're gonna do it one more time, this time with this end and this end. And again, if it's too much, you can kind of move it back. I do want them to overlapping a little bit on the bottom, but I don't want it to be too extreme. So once everything is done, we are just gonna go ahead to join everybody. So it seems like it's a little bit kink over there. So we are going to rebuild it, turning into one big curve. So I'm going to use the command rebuild. And we want to get a little bit more point. Let's do 20 over there. And we'll get the curve like this. Okay, so it looked nice to me. We're gonna make a ring out of it, but if you look at the front view, notice that it's no longer follow the circle. The ring is no longer rounded. So what I like to do is we're gonna do the same thing again. We are going to pick up the original circle, which is our ring size, and I'm going to surface, extrude this straight like this. Okay, and we are going to, instead of using the project that we use, we wanted to have the curve from this one and pull it back to this surface. And you can see like it's just a little bit different. We can delete the original one and keep this one. Now you can see from the front view, it's back to circle again. So let's delete this surface. Now this is the curve that we want. So what we need to do now is to creating a cross section. I'm going to set it about 1.7 millimeters long, and I like to have my ring shank a little bit thicker. So I would like to make a corny corner, and it's about 2 millimeters up, 2 millimeters wide and 2 millimeters up, and then make it slightly corner like this. So we are going to use the move command to move this one from the endpoint or the midpoint, and we want to snap into the intersection over there. Okay, so now this is what we have. Let's do a test and see how it goes. We're going to use the commands called sweep one rail. This is a rail, this is the cross section, and then you can have it go all the way around. Remember, you want to turn on the history. If you want to change it later, that will be great. Okay, so now we are looking at the button. The button seems a little bit too close. At this point, what you can do is you can turn on the control point for the curve that we have and kind of edit the point if you want to. But since this is a projected curve, it might not able to edit smoothly, so you might want to reproject it, re-pull. Another thing that we can do to fix this button looking thing is we can come into the top view and we wanted to chop it where it has the connection there. So let's go ahead to chop it somewhere around here and somewhere around there. Depends on what's the thickness that you want. So we're gonna pick up those two and we're gonna trim it off anything in between. So let's trim it off this one and also this one. Okay, so now we have those two shapes over there. So this is a continuous piece. It's hard to trim each other and there's no split line. The one on the right side, it has a line over there. We can actually explode it and now we can pick up both of them and have them to trim each other. So now they become one piece, we can kind of join it back. On this part, you cannot split into two, so we are just gonna split whatever. So let's go to the top view with this one. We are going to split this one into two, so we are going to use the split command with this curve over there. So now it become two part. Once now it turning into two part, then we can select both of them and trim each other for the place that we don't want it. Okay, and then let's join back. One is done. So now we got two parts over there, right? We are going to use the command called duplicate the edges, and we want to duplicate this edges and that edges. And make sure that you join them together. All right, so now we have this as our cross section. We are going to use the sweep one rail, and this is going to be our rail. We're gonna sweep from here to here. So now you can have the section that's much better into one section over there. After that, you can apply the B setting, and I have a whole playlist for the stone setting. It's been taught in other video, and I also have a course for stone setting. So if you are interested in that, I have the link at the description below. And I greatly appreciate it for a small donation to my channel that's helping me to improve my channel quality and buy the equipment that I need for teaching. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.